Rumpelstiltskin.
Once there was a poor miller who had a beautiful daughter.
On his way into town one day, the miller encountered the king. Wanting to impress him, the miller said, "I have a daughter who knows the art of spinning straw into gold." Now the king had a passion for gold, and such an art intrigued him. So he ordered the miller to send his daughter straight to the castle. When the girl was brought before him, the king led her to a room that was filled with straw. He gave her spools and a spinning wheel and said, "You may spin all night, but if you have not spun this straw into gold by morning, you will have to die." With that, he locked the door, and the girl was left inside alone.
There sat the poor miller's daughter, without the slightest idea how anyone can spin straw into gold. For the life of her, she did not know what to do. She grew more and more frightened, and then she began to weep. Suddenly, the door sprang open, and a tiny man stepped in. "Good evening, Mistress Miller," he said. "Why are you sobbing?" "Oh," the girl cried, "I must spin straw into gold, and I don't know how."
"What will you give me if I spin it for you?" the little man asked.
"My necklace," she answered the girl. The little man took her necklace and sat down on the spinning wheel. He pulled three times, whir, 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 and the spool was wound full gold thread. He fit another spool on, and whir, 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 three pulls, and that one, too, was full. So it went until morning, and then the straw was spun, and all the spools were full of gold.
When the king came at sunrise, he was amazed and delighted, but all the gold only made him greedier. So he led the miller's daughter to a large room filled with straw, and he ordered her to spin straw too before dawn, if she valued her life, that was.
The girl did not know what to do. She began to weep. Once more, the door opened, and the little man stepped in. "Will you give me if I spin the straw into gold for you?" he asked.
"The ring on my finger," answered the girl, and the little man took her ring. Then he set the spinning wheel whirring, and before the night was over, he had spun all the straw into gleaming
Shortly
gold.
Shortly after sunrise, the king returned. Piles of golden spools glowed in the morning light. The king rejoiced at the sight of so much gold, but he still was not satisfied. He led the miller's daughter to a third, even bigger room that was piled so high with straw.
"Tonight you must spin this straw too," he ordered the king, "and if you succeed, you shall become my wife," because he thought if he could not find a richer wife in the world.
When the king had left, the little man appeared for the third time. "What will you give me if I spin this straw yet once more into gold?" he asked. "I have nothing else," the girl replied. "Then promise that when you become queen, your first child will belong to me." The miller's daughter gasped. How could she promise such a thing? When she thought about it, though, she realized that she might never have a daughter or a son. And as she could think of no other way to save herself, she promised a little man once again spun all the straw into gold.
When the king came in the morning and found everything he had wished, he married the miller's beautiful daughter, and she became queen.
A year passed, and the queen brought a handsome baby boy into the world. She gave scarcely thought to the little man, but one day he appeared suddenly in her room. "Now give me what you promised," he demanded. The queen pleaded with the little man. He could take all the royal treasure, and he would only let her keep the child. But her pleading was in vain, and she began to weep so piteously that at last the little man was moved. "I will give you 3 days," he said. "If by the end of the time you know my name, you may keep your child."
Long into the night, the queen sat through the next day thinking over names she had ever heard. That evening, the little man returned, being with Caspar, Melchor, Blatsar. The queen recited every name she knew, one after another, but each one the little man replied, "That is not my name."
For the second day, the queen had inquiries made in town, searching for new names. And when the little man came back that evening, she posted the strangest and most unusual ones to him. She tried Beast Trips, Lego Ram, String Bones, but he would only reply, "That is not my name."
Now the queen grew truly frightened, and she sent her most faithful servant into the woods to look for the little man. The servant searched through the thickets and over clearings deep into the forest. At last, near the top of the hill, she spied.
He was riding on a cooking spoon around a great fire, crying out, "I brew my beer, I bake my loaves, and soon the queen's own son I'll claim. Oh, lucky me, for no one knows that Rumpelstiltskin is my name."
The servant made her way back as fast as she could manage, and midday reached the castle. You can imagine how glad the queen was when she heard the name.
Late that evening, a little man arrived. "Now, Mrs. Queen," he said, "do you know my name, or do I take the child?" So the queen asked him, "Is your name Will?"
"No."
"Is your name Phil?"
"No."
"In that case, is your name Rumpelstiltskin?"
"The devil told you that! The devil told you that!" shrieked Rumpelstiltskin, and in a fury he jumped on his spoon and flew off into the night.
And he was never heard from again.